Welcome back to another episode of the Smith Boys Podcast.
Brother. Oh, cheers, brother. I got to take this one over here for you.
Take it over, brother. So, Jesus, take the wheel.
Yeah, well, Michigan's taking the wheel. And we're taking the Big Ten title.
Oh!
2 years in a row. That's 2 years, Bender. 2 years.
2 years, they got you.
Yep. We got you. So last night, we put a whooping on Purdue. It was not the prettiest of games, I will say.
Second half was a whooping.
Yeah, second half was a whooping.
First half was a little bit close.
The boa constrictor tightened. That's what I call this Michigan team, is the boa constrictor. They tightened up. And they did what they usually do. I will give some shout-outs, though, to Purdue. Aiden O'Connell and is it Chucky Sizzle?
Charlie Jones?
Yeah. Chuck Sizzle? Is that what Gus Johnson was calling his ass all night? He's a good receiver. He's a good, yeah, whatever, Julian Edelman-type guy.
It's like a Cooper Kupp type.
Yeah, Cooper Kupp type guy.
Cooper Star.
Yeah. I don't know. I was pleased with how they played. J.J. played well. Donovan Edwards showed that he is a dude. You know, JJ had the one bad throw that I didn't like. He threw in the triple covered. I mean, brother, he's still young. He's still young.
I don't give a shit.
You really think I give a shit?
I mean, the one throw, the first throw against Colston Loveland.
Bryce Young was young as a sophomore and won a Heisman.
Yeah, whatever.
I mean,
JJ's not Bryce Young. Okay,
I know, but that's just not an excuse that he's young. I mean, he's got weapons around him, and he continually throws horrible balls.
All right. Well, you want to shit all over JJ, but he's 13-0. He's perfect.
I'm not shitting on him, but I mean,
I'm not shitting on you.
Love and praise.
I ain't going to listen to it anymore.
This love and praise everybody gives the guy. It's like the start of the game.
We're not loving and praising.
The start of the game was Donovan Edwards.
Nobody's, you know, ordaining him here, okay? Nobody's anointing him.
What communities have you been in?
Nobody's anointing him.
I got Lions fans saying they want to draft J.J. McCarthy.
Well, those are Lions fans, brother. Those are the dumbest of the dumb.
There's
a whole group of dumb people. Then you take the dumbest of those dumb people. Those are Lions fans, okay? JJ?
Who's dumber than the Lions fans?
There is nobody.
Okay. Well, the star of the game was Donovan Edwards.
JJ was fine. There's nothing wrong with the way JJ played the game.
He plays like that against Georgia.
He's got to play better against
good
Georgia.
Good night.
But Donovan Edwards is a dude. The defense really stood up. Cornelius Johnson made a couple good catches. Colston Loveland played good. Offensive line played good, but I got to give a lot of credit to Purdue. I mean, I really do. They played a really solid football game, gave us a stiff test in the Big Ten title game, much better than Iowa did last year. So I got to give Purdue a lot of credit here. I thought Brom had him prepared for that game.
What was that thing on his neck?
I don't know. It's like some disease. I don't know what he's got going. But overall, I thought... You know, I look back at this Big Ten season, brother, in Michigan. It was just a beautiful thing to watch. It was a very stress-free season.
Oh, my ass, brother. I was here watching the
overall,
games with you.
Overall, it was a stress-free season.
I was over here
season.
Watching the games with you. Give me this stress-free, my ass. You would have had a heart
attack. Every game was the same, brother.
Brother, you were having a heart attack half these games.
It was a stress-free. No, it was a stress-free Michigan season.
You know, if you had been here watching him watch these games, that Illinois game was anything but stress-free.
I was a wreck.
Liar, whore, and you know it.
I was a wreck.
The first half of the Ohio State game was not stress-free.
You weren't here for that one.
No, but we were texting, and it was not stress-free.
Yeah.
And the text message I got.
Second half was.
I'll screenshot them, put them in here.
Second half was stress-free.
Everybody can see what you really say.
All I know is that this is the best Michigan football team I've seen in probably 20 years, going on 25 years. I'm very pleased. I'm very happy. I thank the Michigan football team for such a great season as a fan. Just something beautiful to watch that I haven't seen in a very, very long time. And it makes me giddy. It makes me happy. And it brings a smile on my face right now just talking about this season, talking about Michigan football. I mean, from you started the season, you didn't know what they were. You know, you had Cade, you had JJ. Cade starts against Colorado State, then JJ comes in against Hawaii. And
everyone thinks Jim Harbaugh's out of his mind. Yeah, everybody's like, what the hell, man? Pick a quarterback, dude.
Everybody's killing, you know, Jimmy over this whole thing, and it's kind of like, it all worked out. He had a plan, and he worked that plan, and it's kind of like, huh. Maybe the Monday morning quarterbacks that don't know shit should just shut the hell up and just let the shit play out. Let the games be played and let the results happen.
Huh.
Maybe that's what should happen.
But not when it comes to Dan Campbell, because he's a baboon.
Oh, God. I ain't talking about that idiot-ass baboon. I'm talking about Jimmy Harbaugh. Okay?
Jimmy. Jimmy can coach a game.
Jimmy can coach a game.
Jimmy can wear the black M.
Yeah. Well,
Jimmy's ready. Jimmy's got some new moves.
Go, Jimmy.
Check Jimmy out. Jimmy's down.
Jimmy's got a QB.
It was, again, I mean, we had Blake Corum. We had great players all season. You know, Donovan Edwards. JJ had some spurts. The offensive line was this. It was back to 90s Michigan style of play, where we're churning out offensive linemen into the NFL like it's just something we do, you know. Oluwatemi's going live. Zinter's going live. Ryan Hayes is going to go live. I mean, you got all these guys that are just going to go live. Trevor Keegan's going to go live. I mean, it's just amazing. And we don't even have the pass rush that we had last year. Even though last night I think they showed the stats that we actually had more sacks than we did last year. It sure as hell don't feel like it. But the defense overall, the secondary is what really has stood out to me.
Will Johnson.
Well, Will Johnson, Rod Moore.
Different Will
Bakari
Johnson.
Page.
Not the Will Johnson I went to school with and ended up playing for Michigan. Different
Will
Johnson.
Oh, I remember
Johnson.
Him, yeah.
The defensive lineman. I went to school with him.
Yeah. But just, you know, solid linebacking core. Junior Colson was good. You know, Michael Barrett, great player. The defensive line was solid. You can't run against us. That's the one thing, is like, it's very difficult to run against, you know, the Rashawn Berrys, the Mason Grahams, the Mozzie Smiths of the world. I don't know. I just don't see the Jalen Harrell. Shout out to Jalen Harrell, had a sack.
Yeah.
I just love watching this Michigan team the last 2 years, and I want to thank you. I just want to thank you, Jimmy. I've waited many years, Jimmy, to watch Michigan football like this, and we're dominant. We are officially dominant, and God, it feels so good to watch this. It feels so good to show up every Saturday to just know.
Feels good, don't it, brother?
Oh God,
you know this feeling.
Oh yeah,
this feeling.
It's a wonderful thing.
Feel good?
You know, I remember we were down in Alabama a couple years ago, brother. We were down there and. It was Alabama LSU the first time we went down to Tuscaloosa, and this guy's yelling out at the bar in front of the, not Egan's, but down the road a little bit. And I'm wearing all my Michigan shit head to toe.
He was trolling, brother.
Ah, he's trolling.
On the megaphone.
He's
like, oh, look at this. Here comes a Michigan fan.
Oh, there's one left. There's one Michigan fan left. Yeah, now look at us. Now look at us, you little shit. You pimply little shit.
Okay, you little pimply little shit.
Now look at us. We're 13-0, and you're on the outside looking in.
Hey.
Don't feel too good, does it?
Hey.
Don't, brother.
Don't piss me off. Don't piss me off.
I had to listen to this little pimply little shit rib me all afternoon as we're walking up and down Main Street of Tuscaloosa, and I was like, you know, at least I can add 2 + 2 down here in Sticksville.
Oh, God. We can add 2 + 2, brother. 6.
Right? Yeah. Yeah, it was that common core math there, brother.
I don't know.
Makes you feel good. 2 + 2 = 6. So, yeah, it does.
Something like that.
Yeah. Well, I'd like to meet that little pimply little shit right now, because we're 13-0 and we're in and you're on the outside looking in.
That was at the, he was outside the chicken place, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Chicken roaster place.
Yeah. He was on the south side of that, yeah. By Egan's bar.
Yeah. Across the street from Houndstooth.
Yeah.
You're down in Tuscaloosa, you got to hit Houndstooth. Best place in town.
You have a good night.
Houndstooth's good.
It's good.
It's
crazy.
Such good
night.
Shit.
Yeah. It's such good shit.
Yeah, it's crazy night.
We'll be back, though.
Yeah.
We'll be back.
Yeah.
Next year, we'll be back.
So, that's what I wanted to wrap about a little bit, brother. That was my angle. That was my take.
Well, you better take care of business against TCU.
I have no fear.
Well,
no fear.
Okay, that's good. We'll see what happens. We'll do a post game when that's New Year's Eve.
New Year's Eve, man.
So we'll be doing
4:00.
We'll be doing pods on that come New Year's Eve. So
we'll do a pregame. A few days ahead of that game.
Lots of material that weekend.
Oh, boy, howdy.
Till then, Smith boys.
See ya. Out.